Japanese bolt-action Arisaka rifle. Make sure the weapon's empty. These were originally chambered in 7.7 jet, what is commonly called 7.7 by 58 millimeter. They had a hold open, so when the clip was empty, hold it open. There is a safety mechanism, which you push the rear bolt in and move it over. I'll show it in a second. There's a slot down here that's supposed to also lock the bolt in place. I'm not sure if you can see it, how well you can see it, but there's a little notch there that's supposed to catch on the side of the bolt, but it doesn't on this one. This may be a post-war, or not post-war, near-end war weapon, which causes the condition, the quality control condition, to go down. If you dry fire it, you can see there's a slight bit of headspace issue. This isn't a weapon I would really want to be shooting a whole lot, if at all. Now the action itself, you have a ejector and bolt lock there. Here's where the safety mechanism I was talking about. This little notch here goes into this catch here. Catches right here, and that's what keeps the safety in place. Now the one thing that is sort of neat about this is to take the bolt apart. You just push it in and twist, and you've got the end cap and a little bit of a guide rod. Here's your main spring, or only spring. Here's your firing pin and hammer mechanism. Here's your bolt. The extractor slides off, and that pretty much all as far as you can take it apart. This part's a flat band that's been squeezed around, and I think it's, not sure if it's spot welded. It looks sort of like it might be, but either way, it's just a flat band on the bolt. And your extractor has a little slot it slides into. That's pretty much it. It's about the simplest bolt design I've seen on pretty much anything. Put it back together, it just reassembles. That's it. That's the Arisaka bolt action World War II Japanese service rifle.